We want to begin with breaking news from our investigative unit today, the 7 Eyewitness News I-Team. Our reporter Ed Drantch here in the studio with us now. Ed, I know you've been working with your sources for a couple of days now concerning this case, and I know you've spoken with the police union today.
That's right.
What have you learned today?
I just got off the phone a little while ago with Buffalo Police Benevolent Association attorney Tom Burton, who told me that Joe Aquino, the officer who was hurt here, is and still was and still is convinced that he was shot on Sunday back in Black Rock. I've also learned that it was Buffalo Police Officer Justin Tedesco who shot the suspect, Jose Hernandez-Rossy. Now, let me take you back to Black Rock on Sunday just before 5 o'clock in the afternoon. A source tells me that Aquino and Tedesco ultimately pulled over this suspect because of a drug investigation. That's some new information coming in this noon. So here's what happened. Aquino and Tedesco had been talking to the suspect at the car after they pulled him over. Jose Hernandez-Rossy pulled Aquino into the car, into the driver's side of the car, accelerated, and that caused the car to almost crash into a child. But because Officer Aquino veered with the steering wheel, the child was missed, wound up hitting a house, and the airbag was deployed. So at that point, we know that Officer Aquino was hurt. He got out of the car after being involved in some sort of an altercation with the suspect. He was screaming, "I've been shot, I've been shot." His ear was hanging, and it was bloody. Obviously, there was a lot of blood coming from his head because his ear was hanging off. So the officer Tedesco, who was his partner, said, "I got to get this guy." You know, he was trying to take off. He was trying to flee from the scene.
This went on for a couple of blocks.
It went on for a couple of blocks. It was a police chase. You're absolutely right. And it turns out that it was Officer Tedesco who, as I mentioned, shot the suspect. But Tedesco, it turns out, never saw a gun, Keith. And that's the sticking point here. And what isn't so important here, according to the attorney, and I'm going to quote him directly. If Tedesco reasonably believed his partner had been shot, he had justification to use deadly force under New York state law.
Well, they found no gun. They found no bullet, as far as we know. There's a big, and the attorney general now in Albany is stepping into this case,
right,
because of this question of whether or not this man was armed or not. But you have to wonder what would have caused such severe injuries to this police officer.
Well, and Burton was very clear about that. No one can be sure about what exactly caused those injuries, but again, as I mentioned, Aquino was positive that he was shot and still is positive that he was shot, and he's going to be speaking with homicide detectives today.
All right, we should mention Officer Aquino is home now recovering. He was at ECMC for a couple of days, had surgery the other day, and he's recovering there as this investigation continues. All right, Ed, thanks for your update today.